Before we start, subscribe my channel, press the bell icon and hit like button so you never miss any video from my channel.
10 TV and movie scenes that should never have been deleted. Dudley apologizes, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1. As the film begins, the Dursleys are getting out of town as Harry gets ready for the final confrontation with Voldemort. Dudley comes over, extending a hand and basically apologizes to Harry for all the bad stuff he's put him through. It's a great moment. Dudley admits his horrible behavior and explains that he is truly sorry for all the years of friendship lost between them. Harry is thrown, realizing he misjudged his cousin all this time. It shows great emotion from both actors. The happy mother ending, How I Met Your Mother. Many fans hated the original ending, which is why they much prefer the official alternate ending the showrunners had, which has Ted and Tracy meeting in rain under an umbrella. They look at each other, feeling a connection, and the older Ted states, And that's how I met your mother. It then just has a bit of the cast over the years and ends. No illness, no Barney, Robin breakup, ending with the story of how the mother was the point which fans would much prefer over the aired version. Loki's coronation, Thor, The Dark World. In Thor The Dark World we see Loki being coronated King of Asgard. He's all smiles as he marches out, the crowds applauding and cheering him on. His mother beams with pride and even the Warriors 3 accept him as he takes the throne, embracing his destiny. To top it all off, he would then be worthy to hold Mjolnir over his head. It would then reveal it was just a dream of Loki's before he's going to be sentenced by Odin. However, it showcases his desire and how he just wanted to be loved and accepted. It also smartly foreshadows how he takes on Odin's appearance to become ruler later in the film. Walt's train lesson, Breaking Bad. A deleted scene has Walt doing a big speech talking of the history of great train robberies that were famous for getting a few thousand dollars. He then states how this robbery is going to be bigger than all those combined. It's short but a terrific bit showing the obvious joy Walt has in his criminal life that drove him on and made the show a dark but intriguing ride for viewers. Unkar's arm, The Force Awakens. In a scene showcased on the Blu-ray, while at Maz's castle, Rey is surprised to find Unkar has followed her. He explains he had a beacon on the Falcon and tracked them down and demands his ship back. Rey tries to use a blaster but he mocks her on how the safety is on. However, Chewbacca takes exception to his new friend being mistreated. Showing his lack of intelligence, Unkar actually mocks Chewbacca and shoves him. The next thing we know, Unkar's arm is literally flying across the room to land on a table. It's a great bit to show how protective Chewie is of his friends and closes out this jerk character a lot better. Bill vs. Black Dynamite Kill Bill Volume 2. Among the multiple deleted scenes was a scene where the bride remembers how she and Bill took a trip to China. They're met by a man who wants revenge for Bill slaying his master. Bill easily takes down the man's 4 aides and then engages in a wild sword battle. It's shot like a cheesy 1970s kung fu movie complete with a badly dubbed accent for white. While it was cut for pacing, it does showcase David Carradine looking terrific and shows Bill's skills, which makes him more of a threat for the bride. Hitting them all, X-Men Apocalypse. There are some complaints about the latest movie in the X-Men franchise being too overblown and too many characters. However, it's notable that cutout was a softer bit that showcases the fact these mutants are still basically kids. Cyclops, Jean Grey, and Nightcrawler decide to hit them all, accompanied by young Jubilee. It perfectly captures the 80s vibe, starting off with Safety Dance playing in the background. Nightcrawler is astounded by it all as they hit an old-fashioned arcade with fun bits like Crawler using his tail to play 2 controllers at once. There's also a bit of them buying records and even some breakdancing. It would have been a fun addition to show them more relaxed before the main action cut in and the actors shining well in it. Effie's Makeover, The Hunger Games Mockingjay Part 1. In a deleted scene, she shows the connection she has with Katniss. She shoos people away to do Katniss makeup herself for a propaganda film. She says she needs to make this work, you, me, Dot and Cinna, citing the late stylist who helped Katniss in the earlier movies. It's a great moment that shows the connection the two have and that under all that glitz, Effie truly likes Katniss and wants to help in her own way. Cap has to adjust to modern times, the Avengers. In the audio commentary, Joss Whedon said he hated to cut this scene from the Avengers. However, it just felt rough in pacing as he wanted to get Cap right into the action. Yet this sequence shows how Steve Rogers is adjusting to a world that's moved 70 years without him. Steve wanders around New York, obviously amazed at it all, and then hits it off with a waitress at a diner. This would lead to Stan Lee making a cameo urging Cap to ask her out. The whole scene captures the man out of time aspect. Time is full circle, the Terminator. However, another scene would have brought the time travel effects up even more. Sarah ends up destroying the Terminator by crushing him in a factory press she had stumbled onto. As Sarah is carted to the hospital, we see a pair of technicians finding the remains of the Terminator and intrigued by the high-tech circuitry. The camera then pulls back to reveal the factory is called Cyberdyne. In other words, the Terminator's death basically set the road to creating Skynet and would be a great bit for the viewers to realize how time is full circle.